All right, in this video, I'm going to review the Power of Five article that Facebook published end of March 2019. It's early April 2019 at the recording of this video. And what I want to show you are the five components that Facebook is saying it's telling, you know, advertisers to leverage to optimize and have better ad performance, as well as essentially leveraging the AI. And all these components always have existed in the ads account. These aren't particularly new. It's just that you're leveraging them together to get results, especially nowadays where you're competing with machines essentially for advertisers, for advertisement. What I'm also going to show you are some notes, some nuances that we found, and some notes that you can take into account. So when you're testing these into your own campaigns or your client campaigns, you can make sure you have a heads up, as well as show you just some setups that we have in our own ads account and how we're leveraging these features that Facebook's calling the Power Five. So essentially, the Power Five are essentially five features that Facebook's always had. So automatic placements, campaign budgets, simplification of the campaign, which is it's a little new, but it's actually quite simple, obviously, with that title, right? Auto advanced matching. This is actually on the pixels, and I'll show you how to set that up in dynamic ads. So essentially, some nuances here. When you're using automatic placements, Facebook, essentially, you're giving Facebook the full leverage to go and get the place your ad creatives wherever it sees best. We have in other videos shown that we like to edit those placements and remove content categories like adult content, controversial content, or political content. Typically, you know, that's kind of what we like to do because we don't want our ads going to that low quality traffic. But if Facebook is optimizing for high quality traffic in that regards, we're still testing that. And the auto placements has worked pretty well for us for campaign budget optimization. One of the nuances we're seeing, and you can validate this too with your own testing, is that when you go to scale campaign budgets, sometimes the campaigns don't perform as well as if you leave the budget alone. So some things to combat that or some ideas are get your proven audiences, get your proven ad creatives and using post IDs. Once you have a good mix and you're going to scale, continue your regular scaling techniques in the current campaign where you found those winning audiences and ads. However, if you're going to start a new campaign for campaign budgets, start that at a very high budget because now Facebook can optimize for that particular budget using those particular audiences and those particular ads. So that's just one nuance there. Just to repeat that, just so it's clear, Facebook, we've seen that if you either scale or change a campaign budget after you've launched the campaign, though campaigns don't perform or they have a limited performance, they still work. But we're just seeing that that's a little nuance there. So if you have proven ads and proven audiences using the ad post IDs and you want to get that mix to scale, just to create a new campaign, use campaign budgets and have a higher ad set per day, ad budget per day, like $100, $150, $200, $500, whatever it is that you want to scale at. And that will work. And we see it work better because Facebook optimizes for that particular budget that you set at the campaign budget. For account simplification, I want to go over this with you, account structure. So Facebook's calling it the old way and the power play, quote unquote, the new way. Essentially, it looks like Facebook's almost moving to having in one ad set structure, one to two ad set structures per campaign, almost limiting it to like just optimizing at the ad set level, like how we used to do it. But however, it's essentially campaign budget or the campaigns on top, and you have one or two ad sets in that campaign. Because again, you're using campaign budgets, so you're allowing Facebook to spend the majority of the budget on one or two ad sets. So that's why they're doing this. Reason number one. Reason number two is because then the algorithm doesn't have to, I guess, make more decisions across multiple campaigns on which audiences to show your ads to, which kind of takes away from the idea of having, you know, the campaign budget optimization for the algorithm to choose which audience to send your ad to that specific day. However, if Facebook is asking to simplify the structure, then I think that's where we can move some of our campaigns to. So essentially, if you're going to do this particular setup, just use a proven audience or proven audiences that you've had. And there's several ways you can set this test up or this this structure up. You can either use a combo of lookalikes into one campaign. You can use a one audience and then do big four English speaking countries on one ad set, or you can literally just pull one or two proven audiences and isolate them in their own campaigns at a higher budget with different creatives. And then you can do in a campaign duplication strategy, which I'll show you in just a second, where you just duplicate that campaign with those same audiences at and set different budgets to them and seeing how they perform. Essentially, when you do that, though, you got to make sure that you shut off things quick enough or use the automated rules to shut off ads that are not performing within KPI. Because the worst thing you can do is have a high, like a, you, scaling a campaign and then you're way out of KPI because you didn't shut things off fast enough. So the name of the game is making sure that you shut things off fast and you're testing quickly. So going to advanced matching. This is essentially just in the pixel, and this actually is in Bootcamp 2.0. Is when you go set up the pixel. I'll show you in just a second, actually. So when you go to set up the pixel, go to the pixel install setup, and then you select here automatic advanced matching. This is essentially gathering all that hash data from the users when they visit your website and giving it back to Facebook. So that's what that is in particular. And lastly, Facebook is suggesting to use dynamic ads. And if you don't know what a dynamic ad is essentially, this is mostly for e-commerce. You can set up catalogs, I believe, for info products. It's a little bit trickier, or you just have to make sure that you set it up correctly in the first place. However, you're just using essentially product catalog to deliver the right ad to the relevant market. Or like if they seen like a, for example, if a user goes to your website, sees the product, the hat product, and that's the only product they saw, they're going to get an ad for just the hat product. So that's essentially what dynamic ads are. Now, I will show you some setups that we have. We're not using dynamic ads, but we're using multiple ads in the ad set. And we're also using placement specific creative, such as an Instagram story. And I'll go ahead and show you our setup quickly here. So that's the power of five. And just wrapping that up, if you need to watch this or read this article, it's on facebook.com/business/mpower-5. Let me show you some of our setups here in the ads account. All right, if you notice here, we have essentially three campaigns, and one of those is duplicated out, or two campaigns, and one of those is duplicated out for scaling purposes. If you notice, we have different campaign budgets or different campaigns at the campaign budget with the same budget set up to scale using a duplication strategy. But if you go to the actual campaign itself, it has one ad set. Right, this was targeting the U.S. We used to have some that just big four, but again, it's this account simplification, just one ad set per campaign. But on the ad level, we're using multiple creatives and we're pruning them. You notice we're pruning them based on cost. You see this one? It's obviously this is a newer test, but it's getting $4 opt-ins. It's actually doing really well. Our opt-ins like 10, 15 bucks a KPI, so $4 is well below KPI. But if you notice, these ads actually have a specific story placement for Instagram. And we, and then Jason targeted the US specifically because we're finding that we're getting high quality, low cost traffic from US via the Instagram placement. So if you don't have dynamic ads for your info product, like Facebook suggests, then you can go ahead and just use multiple ads and have placement specific creative, like an image for Instagram only or a video for Instagram stories, and then a different type of image for Facebook news feeds. Doing that allows Facebook's algorithm to really, you know, leverage your creative and put it on the placements that you wanted to at the best optimization, because not a lot of advertisers actually do this. If you notice, they're using the same image or video from Instagram to Facebook to, you know, to the stories or images. And Facebook notices that, and the users notice that too. So if you have a specific creative for a specific placement, highly encourage you do that. I wouldn't do that for every single one, especially if you're doing tests. Maybe just find your control first. And then after you find a control image or video, then you can go ahead and elaborate and expand with different placements using that same control. So that's the power of five in a nutshell. If you have any questions on setting this up, just post it in the group and tag us, and we'd be more than happy to help.